by the sad news of the demise of Sharon. We are indeed at our very, very lowest in life. So at usingisi akuna, at appetite akuna, we are at our very, very lowest.
Obado would, however, not state whether he knew Sharon or not, despite media reports that he had admitted to knowing her during his grilling at the Nyanza provincial headquarters Tuesday.
I'm still ready and willing whenever I'll be called upon to give further statements so that the real killers of Sharon can be brought to book.
Hours after Obado spoke, another twist in the investigations. Detectives picking up two suspects in Nairobi's Kayole estate believed to have been part of the abductors. The two were said to have been placed at the scene through tracking of their mobile phones. They were taken to the DCI headquarters for questioning and are expected to be charged in court Thursday. Obado's PA, Michael Oyamo, who is already before court over the killing, was earlier in the day denied a bail and remanded for a further 14 days pending more investigations.
You may be charged with murder contrary to section 203 as read with section 204 of the Penal Code of the Laws of Kenya. And the particulars of the offence are that between 3rd and 4th September 2018 at Owande area, Rachonyo, South Sub-County within Homa Bay County, jointly with others not before court, you murdered Sharon Beryl Otieno.
Even as mystery continues to shroud the finer details behind Sharon's murder, it is a case that has attracted public outcry and the demand not just for answers but for justice, with this being a case not just being adjudicated before the actual courts but before the court of public opinion as well. Jackie Maribe, Citizen TV, Nairobi.